Welcome back. I'm Curtis Smith, and we have a question from Farzad, who wrote to us on the internet. He said, I want to know about the death of leaves. In other words, what are the reasons that leaves fall from trees? And I've got two foresters here to help me answer that question. I've got Bob Bell from PNM, George Duda with New Mexico State Forestry. What are your opinions of this? What are the reasons and, you know, what causes leaves to fall from the trees?
Well, this morning I came out here and I could see my breath. It was getting cool. So that's one reason. Also, the photoperiod changes how leaves and trees function. And at that time of year, the tree begins to change color. We see this glorious fall color in the Schumard oak here, and the leaves begin to fall.
You know, the leaves would freeze if they stayed on the tree. These aren't designed to work in the cold weather.
Right.
So the tree might as well dispose of them so they don't become a liability.
Absolutely. Trees that have evolved in the northern hemisphere, and actually in the southern hemisphere too, away from the tropics, have evolved to survive the winter by losing, shedding their leaves. It's just the natural way that they prevent from being injured by the winter.
And they have special mechanisms to do that.
That is correct. As the winter progresses, as the days get cooler, the nights get cooler, and the days get shorter, the leaf develops an abscission zone where the base of the leaf contacts the twig. And that abscission zone, there's actually a plant hormone called abscisic acid, which collects at the abscission zone, and it helps the leaf shed naturally from the twig.
It causes actually some special cells to form, or to some cell wall to form that separates the cells, so they will just fall apart. Now, these aren't ready to fall yet.
No, this is a Schumard oak, and the oaks will typically hold on to their leaves a little bit longer, a little bit later than many of the other species that we run into.
But over here we have a big-tooth maple, and the maple drops its leaves a lot more readily. The abscission zones are formed, so as we take some of these leaves that have colored up pretty well and pull back slightly, if I can find one that's there, it just snaps right off. And so the abscission zone was there. And Jean in Roswell sent us a question as well, and she asked, can a disease enter through the wound made when a leaf falls from the tree?
Well, George, I'm sure, can address this as well, but this is the way the tree is made. Can a disease enter? Well, a disease, if it's aggressive enough, can certainly enter a tree in a number of different ways. It's highly unlikely that disease is going to enter through a naturally shed leaf.
And it has that abscission zone, which actually seals it.
It's a barrier to the external world, yes.
And one of the other things we know in pruning trees is 1- and 2-year-old wood has a special capability of protecting, walling off the disease and stopping it.
Yes.
And so this is in 1-year-old wood. And so again, it's not very likely to be a problem.
And consider the age of trees in our communities. We have some very old trees. They've been doing this for years and they're doing fine.
Okay. Well, Farzad and Jean, thanks for the questions about the leaves.
Yeah.
We also got a question from Carolyn in Albuquerque who asked, what is the procedure for legally cutting a Christmas tree from the forest in New Mexico? George Duda with New Mexico State Forestry has that answer for us. So George, can you answer that one?
Sure. If a person or a family wants to go out and collect their own Christmas tree, it's a wonderful experience. Go out to the forest, but before you do that, contact your local United States Forest Service office in your area and ask them what areas are available for Christmas tree harvesting. And if they have an area in their national forest, you can purchase a permit to cut a Christmas tree. This particular tree is a white fir. It is a native to New Mexico. It's one of the classic Christmas trees that we grow in New Mexico. Another very popular Christmas tree now is the piñon itself. And the fragrance of that tree in your house is wonderful, in addition to the beauty and the lighting of those trees during our holiday season.
Okay, if there's forest on private land, how do they go about getting permission to take a tree from private land?
Once again, no matter where you cut that tree, go to the ownership of that tree. If it's a private landowner, knock on the door, ask permission to cut that tree. Always get permission to cut that tree.
And then once they've cut it, are there certain procedures they have to follow so that they can prove they legally have that tree?
Yes. You need to have a bill of sale for transporting that tree. The bill of sale from the United States Forest Service is your permit. A written slip of the owner of private property can serve the same purpose.
And I know when I've bought these tags before, the permit is essentially a tag.
That
has to be affixed to the tree
as
you're carrying it out.
That's correct. That is your permit, essentially.
And that's a bright orange one that keeps you out of jail.
And it's no problem cutting trees in New Mexico's forests. Typically, we have too many trees in our forests, and using natural trees like this beautiful white fir actually thins the forest and allows more mature trees to carry on better life in the forest.
Reduces fire hazard and other such. But choose a tree that's not the one sitting out by itself that has a perfect form.
Right.
Choose one that has a flat side so you can put it against a wall.
Exactly.
George, thank you.
Of course, thank you, Curtis.